is from Right Chair Diaries, Nova Scotia, Canada, and I am going to talk about True Romance, directed by Tony Scott from 1993, script by Quentin Tarantino. Major stars are Christian Slater, Patricia Arquette, Dennis Hopper, and a cast of star turns, Brad Pitt, Gary Oldman in a costume and hair that forever burned into my eyeballs. I don't think I'll ever forget the outfit. Samuel L. Jackson does this as a bit. Did I mention Christopher Walken? Bronson Pinchot, Val Kilmer as the ghost of Elvis, basically. This is a budget director's cut. And one side is formatted or for full screen, the other side's widescreen, and then it ended up, it says enhanced for widescreen TVs, but my widescreen TV in the living room, it's too narrow. And considering that Christian Slater's character, Clarence, is driving a 1980s Cadillac, a pink Cadillac convertible of all things, it looks like he's driving an aircraft carrier, because everything in this particular budget one is extremely widescreen, so they're all kind of distorted. So at some point in the future, maybe I'll get a better copy. I liked it quite a bit. It is cartoon violence, because it's just too much. It's over the top. And so I think it's a black comedy more than anything else. I'm going to have to discuss some plot points here. I mean, we've seen it a dozen times, maybe a dozen times in movies, where somebody ends up with somebody's drugs, a drug shipment, or illicit drugs, I should say, or the money from that sort of, you know, deal gone bad, and there's all this gunfighting and all of this. And then they always think that they can get away. Well, that's actually what happens, is you've got Clarence and Alabama, I think is her name. Is that what she goes by? Yeah, Alabama. Patricia Arquette. Let's go to Los Angeles. Our friend Michael Rapaport is trying to break into acting. We could stay with him while they're running around with the cocaine. And, of course, all the mayhem. Mayhem like you wouldn't believe. So I'd like to say, without giving away all the plot points, it most definitely is a black comedy, because it's very funny. Just what people are wearing, just the sort of star turns, like Christopher Walken as a villain, and the monologue by Dennis Hopper explaining genetic lineage of Sicilians. Very, very, very funny. And of course, politically incorrect. It's written by Quentin Tarantino, so God love him. Talk about the N-word. It's in this one, that's for sure. So that is very, very funny. It doesn't end well, but it's funny. And just, you know, the fact that Clarence and Alabama fall in love after one night, and the whole thing is just completely ridiculous and very funny. And I cannot believe how soundproof these rooms in this luxury hotel are, that they can have multiple firearms going off all the time, and you can't even hear it in the hallway when you're, nor in the adjacent bathroom. It's very, very funny. So it just is so well photographed. I mean, the action is all very stylized. It's extremely captivating, you know? So it's a familiar sort of story with a lot of humor to it, which is from, you know, the Quentin Tarantino humor in the middle of all this mayhem and all this death. It's very, very funny. But I'm always uncomfortable when people are being beat up on screen. That's the worst to me, is when somebody's being kicked and slapped and all bludgeoned and all of that sort of stuff. But I got through it. It because it's very much like watching the Roadrunner and Wile E. Coyote. We've got Brad Pitt. I don't think gets off the couch in the movie in his drug-induced stupor as a roommate for Michael Rapaport, and that was actually quite well played as well. Music soundtrack's terrific. It starts out in Detroit, and you've got a color palette that is like dystopia. It is so miserable and cold and snowy and slushy, and it's like a pimple on the asshole of the world. You know, it's like it's completely unattractive the way it's photographed. How Dennis Hopper has a trailer next to that railroad going by with the freight trains, I do not know. You've got and there's another place with trains in it, then you've got somebody by an airport, and it's just, you know, like no wonder they took the drugs and left, right? And then you get to LA and it's sunshine and bright colors, and I mean, that's all very simplistic cinematography as far as the goal and the palette. Achieving it, you know, not a simple. But, you know, just all very sunshiny, and of course, all of these bodies piling up throughout the course of the 2 hours. James Gandolfini, before he was famous as Tony Soprano, not one of my favorites. I'm not a big fan of his, I don't think. I don't know, something about his style of acting that is very, very lauded by critics, but I don't see it. But you know, that's just me. Maybe it's just a stylistic thing that I don't care for. So I don't want to tell you everything that happens in it, but I think you can pretty well figure it out. Tony Scott, who died last year, this is 2013. I'm recording this February 11th, 2013, for my Virgin Cinema Festival in April. Because if I've seen this, I don't remember it, so I'm considering that I haven't seen it. I think Ted saw it. What's wrong with me? The music by Hans Zimmer, sort of usual Hans Zimmer stuff, as far as I'm concerned. I'm not a big fan either. But my favorite Tony Scott movie, of course, is The Hunger, which is from 10 years before. That's one goblet of wine. I don't really know what else I want to say about it, but I do recommend it if you like mayhem, if you like a good soundtrack, if you like Quentin Tarantino, excess, it's all here. And I probably wouldn't be able to tell the difference if Quentin Tarantino directed it or Tony Scott directed it. I mean, that collaboration must be awfully close on this, because it seemed like a Quentin Tarantino movie to me. I mean, you had Samuel L. Jackson in there for one thing as well. And just the witty dialogue, you know, between Bronson Pinchot and Saul Rubinek and Christian Slater, you know, it's just very, very funny stuff, you know, and you really have to pay attention to it. Anyway, from 1993, Tony Scott's True Romance, and very, very good. Quite recommended it. And this is, I think, Cinerama's favorite Tony Scott movie, and I can see why. It doesn't seem to have aged, because it's 20 years old, and I quite loved it. This is Michael Rentier Diaries. I'll see you around the 2.